the Adrian College Sports Network wants you to join us in thanking one of our sponsors, the Carlton Lodge of Adrian. The Carlton Lodge offers a comfortable and convenient lodging experience. Carlton has spacious rooms and suites fit for a peaceful night's sleep. Their amenities include a hot tub and pool, a 24-hour fitness center, a business center, and much more. A huge thanks to Adrian College's choice of lodging for sponsoring Bulldog Athletics.
Adrian College has dozens of athletics programs, and winning is a staple on our campus. We have the culture of winning in and out of the classroom. This is a place where young men and women grow into professionals for life. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit AdrianBulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time.
Hello students, this is President Dockin coming to you again from the President's office at Adrian College. Hey, I'm sending you this video with some great news. Despite all that's been happening with the pandemic, COVID-19, etc., we've been hard at work on campus, and the faculty have recently approved eight new degree programs, which I think are super exciting. And I want you guys to know about these so you can start to think about them as you think about your future academic career here. So here they are. The first one is in public health. We have both a major and a minor now in public health. Can you think of a more relevant major than public health right now, given all that's going on? The second one is supply chain management. If you're following the news, supply chain management is really where it's at. There are thousands of jobs. I happened to look before I got in this video. Some of these jobs pay over $100,000 a year right out of college. Public health pays very well as well. Great area to go into. The third new major that the faculty approved is human resources. And you know, every business, I mean, whether it's Adrian College or IBM or something in between, has a human resource office. Lots of jobs, great field to go into. The fourth is professional sales. Now, whatever your professional career, you have to know how to sell, whether you're selling yourself, whether you're selling goods, whether you're selling services, whether you're selling your character. Professional sales is a great thing to be trained in academically. The next one is esports management. Now, esports is just absolutely exploding across the country. And I know we have a lot of students that are athletes that would like to stay into sports. So we now have an esports minor degree. It's a minor right now, may turn into a major later, but it's a minor right now that you can get your degree in. And then we have two certificates that we're now offering in digital marketing, which is incredible. I mean, digital marketing, again, whatever you're going into, if you can do some digital marketing, your employers will love it. So these are high skill, high pay, high need areas with literally thousands of jobs coast to coast. So long and short is, once again, Adrian's on the cutting edge. We're at the forefront. We are leading the pack in innovation and ingenuity. And we just wanted you guys to know all that's going on. So there you go. It's all good news today. I hope that brightened your day. Thanks for tuning in.
Are you looking to continue your athletic career while also pursuing your educational career? Adrian College houses dozens of varsity and club programs right here on campus, along with 77 undergraduate degrees and 47 majors. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit AdrianBulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time.
She scores! And Adrian with a dream start in the finals of the MIAA tournament.
Right now. Whoa! Leon got the crowd into it. He fired! Oh my goodness! How in the world? That will do it! Sticks fly into the ceiling. The Bulldogs take to the ice. The Harris Cup to Adrian.
I don't even know what we say about it. Like, I'm kind of left speechless after that game.
Next prize representing United States of America, Adrian College.
Hey, there he is, Bruiser. Hi, I'm Bruiser's biggest fan. He was a legend to us puppies.
Strong but silent. Such a humble attitude from such a prominent figure.
He ran Adrian College's campus. Everyone loved him and wanted to meet him wherever he went. Welcome week, homecoming, spring concert. He was there and looking good. Well, he did have his own private groomer. He was so cool. He had the best education a bulldog could ever ask for, as many walks as he wanted. Heck, the dog had his own past Richie. Bruiser was an athlete, but I'm so small. He did have to work hard at it. Well, maybe not too hard, but it will take a lot of commitment and practice. I want to land on varsity at Arrington too. It's just such a big jersey to fill. Seriously, huge. But I can do this. I want the job. Because I want to make thousands of Bulldog friends just like him. So hi, Adrian College. I'm Bruiser too.
Time I'd like to introduce President Docking.
16 years I've been doing this, saying hello to freshman groups coming in. But obviously this one's different. The friends that you're going to make, the experiences that you're going to have, the memories that you will create are just amazing.
Oh, out till midnight. I say we lose
gentlemen, boys and girls, people at home and abroad, and thank you for tuning in to the Adrian College Sports Network, Adrian College Television, and WBAC Adrian. You're in for a show this afternoon, as it's going to be the Aurora Spartans taking on your Adrian College Bulldogs. Hi again, everybody. I'm Trey Matthews, your play-by-play announcer. Joining me on my right is Matthew Kibbe. And Matthew, you've called a good chunk of NCAA women's hockey for this Adrian College program. What can we expect in their matchup against Aurora?
Yeah, you're going to want to expect a lot of speed on the ice. The Spartans are going to have to play a strong defense, and they're going to need to be led by their senior goaltender in net. But on the other end, the Bulldogs, like I said, a lot of speed, going to need to utilize it, get those open passes, take your time, don't go for the big play early, know that you can set up your offense and get a lot of shots on net.
Adrian College Bulldogs 8-0 of the year against the NCHA. They are 1-0. This is going to be the Spartans of Aurora's first NCHA matchup. These two teams have played previously in which the Bulldogs have come out victorious, but those were counted as exhibition games on January the 29th, in which they came out victorious by a score of 7-1, and on January 30th, in which they came out victorious by a score of 4-0. They will play tomorrow in a rematch at Aurora Spartans Barn. So, Matthew, any final thoughts before we send it to a break?
Yeah, you know, I think it's going to be a really good game. Coach Skelly's been working with these girls all winter long, one of the few teams that was able to play during the fall semester. And, you know, they've had a lot of bonding experience. You know, you think about the fact that they went out to Devil's Lake as a team and had a little three-on-three pond hockey tournament, something that you don't usually see. And one of the benefits of being here at little old Adrian is you have the benefit of the boat. You can go and have those team bonding experiences and know that when it comes down to it, you're going to get back on the ice and you're going to be a big family like everybody here at the rink is. And, you know, always a good instance when you're on the doubleheader hockey, you get to be that first game and put the Bulldogs ahead and start off the night 1-0.
Yeah, you talked about them going to Devil's Lake to play some outdoor hockey. Just the experience of that, I couldn't imagine it. I'm sure it was a very great opportunity for all the Adrian College hockey programs just to play some outdoor hockey, just have some team bonding exercise. You don't get that too often at some other rinks or some other places in Michigan or just in the country in general. So that's a very enjoyable experience for all of us. We had fun airing at ACTV. And before the start of the game, we are going to take a quick break. Don't go anywhere. There's still more in store on the Adrian College Sports Network. I'm Trey Matthews, along with Matthew Kibbe. Don't go anywhere.
College has dozens of athletics programs, and winning is a staple on our campus. We have the culture of winning in and out of the classroom. This is a place where young men and women grow into professionals for life. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit AdrianBulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time. Adrian College has dozens of athletics programs, and winning is a staple on our campus. We have the culture of winning in and out of the classroom. This is a place where young men and women grow into professionals for life. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit AdrianBulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time.
Bulldog fans, connect with Adrian College TV on social media to be updated when we're broadcasting live, to see highlights, plays of the week, and much more. Adrian College Television is on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. ACTV's handle is at Adrian College TV on every form of social media. Thank you for tuning in and subscribing to the home of the Bulldogs, Adrian College TV.
Continue to take pride and learn from Asa Mahan's leadership today.
And the slam!
161 years of commitment to harnessing the power of creativity, ingenuity, community, and academic excellence.
I believe that if you get your degree here, the world is going to feel like it's shrinking to you.
Welcome back to Arrington Ice Arena, where we're just about ready for the puck drop to begin period number one here at Arrington Ice Arena on the beautiful campus of Adrian College. If you're just joining in, welcome. I'm Trey Matthews, the play-by-play announcer. Joining me on my right is Matthew Kibbe. And Matt, we are ready for the opening faceoff. Are you ready?
It's going to be a good one.
Von Rudin is going to greet it for the Bulldogs, and it's going to go to the Adrian College Bulldogs as they're going to strike first, and they are going to head into the defending zone. They're going to rattle it around. Bosse just tips it over to one of her teammates. It goes in to the southeast corner. Aurora has possession of it now. Clanks it off the boards. It's going to go back to the point for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Van Ruden has possession of it. Takes it behind the goalie line. Looking for one of her teammates at the point. Loses possession of it, but knifes it away are the Adrian College Bulldogs. And it goes into neutral zone, and it's going to go to the Spartans of Aurora. They're charging up the way, but there to greet them are the Adrian College Bulldogs. It goes behind Yandova. Ballon just able to just rattle it over to the northeast corner here at Arrington Ice Arena. Now back at the point area are the Adrian College Bulldogs. They're going to look to reset. Goes over to Ballon. Now goes back into neutral base. Anderson is just going to dump it in. Line shift for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Spartans will also make a change of substitutions. Playing along the boards, looking for one of her teammates. Still playing along the boards near the southeast corner. Now going below the goalie line. Looking for an opening. Shots on goal differential, still 0-0. We have played about a minute and 40 seconds here at Arrington Ice Arena. Now it's going to go back into neutral base. Aurora trying to charge the way, but they're just going to trash the puck. And it's going to go behind Yandova. Knifing it over to one of her teammates. Shembri tries to take possession of the puck, but greeted by a bunch of Spartans. Now hustling for the puck for Aurora is number 21. And that was Ed. Now they take control of the puck in neutral zone. Shembri, the captain, has possession of it. Just clanks it off the boards. Rattles around once again. Line shift for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Spartans of Aurora have possession of it now. Now shoots it in. Nice stop by Fosse. And on there on the rebound are the Spartans of Aurora. They take possession of it into the southwest corner. Trying to get into neutral zone. They do so once again. And just dumping the puck is Campbell for Aurora.
Nessa Miller made a really good play in the offensive zone. That led to a shot opportunity there. But Fosse, like you said, made a great save.
Dumps in the puck as the Spartans are going to make a line shift. So it's going to go into the possession of the Adrian College Bulldogs. Corbett has possession of it now. Trying to skate up the way of the rink. Passing it over to Miller. Miller just clanks it off the boards once again in neutral zone. Petrowski tries to make a stop. now having possession of it for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Playing along the boards near their bench. Knifing at it. Going back to Corbett. Corbett takes it behind Yondova. Looking to her left, looking to her right. She's going to pass it over to her right. Looks like that is number seven, Finn Riley. Now going down the other way. Trying to go deep in the zone. Tries to shoot it in. Go back door. Petrowski, unfortunately, is rejected by Fosse. Nice save right there. Petrowski, one of the many Adrian College television workers. We love having her. Takes a lot of great camera work. Now goes into neutral zone. Having possession of it are the Adrian College Bulldogs. Trying to pass it around. Rattles in. Line shift for both respective teams. Spartans just knifing at it. 16:45 remaining in period number one. Score is still tied 0-0 here on the Adrian College Sports Network. Adrian College Television and WVAC Adrian. Now goes into neutral zone, hustling for the puck. 2-on-1 right now, but the Bulldogs are back to greet him. And that is number 27, Tupper. Tupper has possession of it. Now passing up ahead. Goes to the Aurora State Spartans. Over to Cook. Goes behind Yondova once again, going into the northwest corner here at Arrington Ice Arena. A little bit of a battle for the puck as it's jammed along the boards. Now passing up ahead. Back into neutral zone. Cordette has possession of it now. Passing it over to her teammate Stemple. Stemple loses possession of the puck and just trashes it as the Bulldogs and the Spartans are going to make a line shift. So Spartans have possession of it now. Playing along the boards.
It's a little interesting storyline. Kaylee Catterett was a scratch earlier today, playing on the ice now for the Adrian College Bulldogs.
In the southwest corner, trying to play out front. Aurora there to just bat it away. It's going to go back into the neutral zone. Bulldogs are going to have to come back and reset. Having possession of it is Trubin. Hitting over to Von Ruden. Von Ruden loses possession of the puck. Now over to the Aurora Spartans. They're just going to hit the puck near the bench of the Adrian College Bulldogs. A little bit of a check right there. Von Ruden fishes the puck out. Back over to her teammate, Ballon. Now in neutral zone, the Spartans looking to reset. And the Adrian College Bulldogs are swarming them. Von Ruden, nice to the way. Una Bellin takes control of the puck. Now charging up the way of the rink. Goes behind the goalie line, looking to center off a pass to get a shot. Grias was trying to get it. Riley at the point, passing it over to Trubin. Trubin tries to pass it out in front. Nice stop by the Spartans. Shots on goal differential is 3-0 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. Grias takes it into the southeast corner. Bulldogs have it stuck right now. Substitution for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Checking in at the wrong possible time. This could be trouble. On the open breakaway, Yondova's going to have to keep her composure. And she does. Goes wide of the post. And the Spartans are going to regain control of it. In the attacking zone here at Arrington Ice Arena. Wow. Yondova is going to hold on to the puck and freeze the action. So we're going to get a quick pause in the action with 14:27 remaining in period number one. Score is still tied 0-0.
What? That's the first whistle of the contest today. And it took all the way until 14:27, Mark. But what an introduction for Denise Yondova to be introduced to this game. Gets a quick breakaway shot and a leg pad save. Exactly what you want to see out of your star goaltender.
Exactly, Bulldogs and the Spartans off to a great start. Petrowski charging up the way of the zone, but is greeted by a bunch of Spartans. Goes below the goalie line, now into the southwest corner. The man in front of at the point is Riley. Riley trying to hit it in, goes over to Miller. Miller takes it into the southwest corner. Now back to Riley at the point. Riley passes over to one of her teammates, tries to knock it down, but the Spartans are able to make a few great stops. They're going to dump the puck in. It goes right to Yondova, so she's going to pass over to Riley. No check that. She's going to hold on to the puck, freeze action once again. So we're going to get ready for another faceoff in the attacking zone here in period number one here at Adrian College Sports Network.
You know, I like what Aurora is trying to do here. They're trying to set up their forecheck. They haven't been able to do so thus far. The Bulldog backcheck has been really good to get to that puck and prevent Aurora from setting up their offense today.
We're going to get ready for the faceoff near the northwest corner here at Arrington Ice Arena. Taking possession of it is Anderson for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Now passing up the way to Shembri. Shembri loses possession of the puck. It's going to go over to Gallinaro for the Spartans. She's going to rattle it home. Now goes into neutral zone, charging up the way of the rink, 2-on-2. Anderson there to greet her. Swipes it away into the northwest corner of the attacking zone, below Yondova. Wide open shot for Gallinaro. Goes wide of the post. Yondova didn't even need to make a stop. Now absolute bedlam near the crease of the doorstep, near Yondova, and she's going to hold on to the puck. Freeze action once again. Get ready for another faceoff, Matt.
Aurora had a woman in front to screen Yandova. She didn't see that first shot. Luckily, it went wide. Scrambled back to her post, able to get the leg pads down and keep out of the back of the net. Now remember, Yandova broke the career shutout record here for this women's hockey team against these Aurora Spartans a few weeks ago.
Shots on goal differential 6-3 in favor of the Spartans of Aurora. Score is still tied 0-0 with 13:22 remaining in period number one. Thank you for tuning into the Adrian College Sports Network. I'm Trey Matthews, the play-by-play announcer. You're listening on WBAC. Adrian, the Bulldogs are right now have possession of it in the attacking zone. Thank you for tuning into Adrian College Television on YouTube. Rattles it around the northwest corner. Tries to go to the Aurora player, but she gets tripped up. That was Dunbar. Now charging up the way of the rink. Looking for a back door and a leg pad stop by Fosse. Excellent play right there. Goes back to the point area for the Adrian College Bulldogs as it's playing along the boards of the defending zone in the south side of the rink. Puck is tipped near the bench for Aurora. Now it goes back to the Adrian College Bulldogs. They're going to pass it up ahead in neutral zone. There to greet it is their captain for Aurora. That was number 24, Martel. Now back over to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Just passing it around in their own zone, looking to pass it up ahead into the neutral zone. Von Ruden, one of the alternate captains for this team, gets tripped up into the boards a little bit. Line shift for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Spartans have full control of the puck right now. Now goes back to the Spartans near Fosse. Playing along the southwest corner, below the goalie line. Sorrell has possession of it now in the southeast corner. Now back to the Aurora Spartans. They're charging up the zone. 2-on-1 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. Now it's going to the northeast corner. Looking to reset. They take it deep into the zone, and the Bulldogs are able to easily swipe it away. They're going to try to take it into neutral zone, and they do so. Excellent pass by Sorrell. Charging 1-on-1. Direct strike once again near the crease area. Are they on the rebound? Was Sorrell, but she misses it. It goes wide of the post.
I think that one hit the post.
Hit the post, wide of the post. Unfortunately, just didn't go in. Neutral zone once again for the Spartans of Aurora. Passing it away. Now into neutral zone. Riley has possession of the puck, trying to maneuver. Cordette trying to swipe the puck away, but is greeted by an Aurora Spartan. Line shift for the Adrian College Bulldogs. 11:15 remaining in period number one. Score is tied 0-0. Haven't seen too many pauses in the action, and we're almost halfway done with period number one. Just a couple of freezes of the puck, and no penalties still by either team. Houdanish, having possession of the puck, tries to take it past the blue line, checked into the boards, near the southeast corner, and near the bench for Aurora. Puck is jammed. Miller has possession of the puck, and it's batted away. Goes into the southwest corner, now below the goalie line. Petrowski has possession of it, tries to do a wraparound shot. Stemple tries to shoot it, and it goes wide of the post. Rattles it around the southwest corner. Aurora trying to pass it up ahead. It comes up unsuccessful. Hustling for the puck is number 22, Jessica Anderson. And icing is the call. We are going to go down the other way for a faceoff.
You know, one of the storylines that I kind of want to keep an eye on tonight is going to be in the stat category. Between two Bulldogs, Una Bellin and Kaylee Catterett, both of them are battling for the team leading goals. Each of them have 6 goals on the year.
Well, let's see who can win that contest. Maybe it'll come accomplished tonight. Grias has possession of it. Looking for one of her teammates. Looks like it's Anderson. Anderson and Grias are right now tussling for the puck near the southeast corner of the defending zone. At the point, lets one fire. Weak stick. It's going to go into the southwest corner. Doesn't even touch the netminder for the Spartans of Fosse. Demanding for it is Tupper. She shoots it in. Goes high of the crossbar. Now goes into the southwest corner. Anderson all alone once again. Lets one fire. Goes wide. Way too far to the right of Fosse to do anything with it. Now goes into neutral base. It's tipped, so the icing will be waved off. So Adrian College Bulldogs have possession of it now. Anderson passing it up ahead to Carmen Anderson. Puck is played along the boards near the penalty box for the Adrian College Bulldogs in neutral zone. 4 Spartans and 3 Bulldogs. Who wants possession of it more? Looks like it's going to be the Bulldogs. Anderson goes deep into the post. Shoots it in. Excellent chest stop by Fosse. She freezes the puck, and we're going to get ready for a faceoff as substitutions come in for the Adrian College Bulldogs. 9:25 remaining in period number one.
Carmen Anderson not used to being on that front side there. She was usually on the left. She was on the right there looking for her captain, Brooke Shembri. Put a little bit too much mustard on that pass, and Shembri couldn't get good control of it to put on a good shot.
Faceoff was not done correctly, so false start. They're going to try this again near the southeast corner. And it's going to go to the Adrian College Bulldogs as they rattle it around the southeast corner of the defending zone. Lets one fire, blocked out in front by the Spartans. It goes into neutral zone. They have possession of it, charging up the way of the rink, greeted by a bunch of Bulldogs players. Can they make the stop? They can. Shots on goal differential is 7-2 in favor of Adrian College. Going deep into the zone, trying to go into Yandova's crease area, but the Bulldogs are able to just knife it away. Bellin over to Von Ruden. Going deep into the zone, and swiped away were the Spartans. And it's going to go to the Adrian College Bulldogs once again into the southeast corner of the defending zone. Puck is stuck along the boards, trying to fish it out. Planks it off the boards near the south side of the rink. 8:38 remaining in period number one, all alone. Is she going to let one fire? Hits nothing but air, and it goes out of the zone. Bulldogs are going to have to come back and reset. Check that. They just tip it in, and it's going to go to the Aurora Spartans, as the Bulldogs are going to make a line shift. Yandova warning her team of the icing, and icing is the call. Riley got there first. We're going to go down the other way for a faceoff.
You know, Aurora hasn't really had a chance to establish their offensive zone presence. It's been all Bulldogs here in the first period. You got to keep that up. If you're Aurora, I think they're trying to take that long pass and get it out of the zone, and in some cases you have to because of how much pressure the Bulldogs have put on you. But I think if you can shorten up those passes, get it to the center ice, and get it into the offensive zone, you'll be better off.
Cataract loses the faceoff for the Adrian College Bulldogs, but they're able to regain control of it. Now playing along the boards, a couple of players hit the rink, and whistle is going to be called. Referees are going to freeze the action.
They're going to send this outside of the offensive zone. They will. Wow. So they're calling that a whistle there because of Diversa falling on it. Puck's not able to get moved, so the official's calling it to come out into the neutral zone for the faceoff, and that's going to hurt the Bulldogs a little bit, not getting an offensive zone faceoff.
Well, doing the faceoff is going to be Cataract. And for the Spartans, it's going to be Dunbar. Knifing it. It's going to go to the Spartans as they are going to rattle it around the southwest corner. Takes it below Fosse. And the Spartans are charging the way up the rink, but greeted by a bunch of girls in white jerseys. 7:50 remaining in period number one on the Adrian College Sports Network. Bulldogs trying to work from left to right on your radio dial. Cataract has possession of it, takes it into the northeast corner of the attacking zone. Playing along the boards, Riley. Back over to one of her teammates. Looks like that was Corbett. Playing along the boards right now, the puck is stuck. Who wants possession of it more? Two Spartans, two Bulldogs. And it's going to go to the Spartans. They're going to be wide open at the point area. Tries to let one fire and block down front. Someone loses their stick in the process. Tries to go back door once again, but Yandova is able to just save that puck away. Adrian College Bulldogs trying to knife at it. And it's going to go back to Riley for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Cataract trying to take it up the zone, but is greeted by number 17 for the Aurora Spartans, Campoli. Playing along the boards in neutral zone. Riley has possession of it now. Trying to pass it away, but it is swiped by number 6, Campbell, for the Spartans. Now going up the way of the rink, it goes into the northwest corner of the attacking zone. Miller has possession of it now. Cross pass over to number 17, Hundanish. Now Miller, they try to do a little bit of a pass. Wide open is Anderson, lets one fire, knocked down in front by the Spartans.
Posey made a good save there, had some screens in front of her, but was able to see that puck all the way through and keep it out of the back of the net.
Anderson hustling for the puck. She gets possession of it. Miller is right ahead of her, and she's going to dish it off to Miller. Miller is going to try to pitch it to one of her teammates. She does so and gives it off to number 11, Reagan Petrowski. Now goes into the zone for Adrian College. Now back into the attacking zone. Hustling for the puck is Anderson. She's able to just bat the puck away for a brief second from Martinez. Petrowski has possession of it now in neutral zone, passing up ahead to Anderson. Anderson going deep and is rejected by the defense for the Spartans. rattles it around, giving off to Grias. Grias is greeted by the Spartans once again. Shembri trying to knife at it, jabs at it. And the puck is going to go back to Anderson, Carmen to be exact. Goes into the southeast corner of the defending zone. Grias trying to get the puck out of the mud. Playing along the boards. Goes into the southwest corner, rattles it to Shembri. Shembri giving off to one of her teammates, Tupper. They're on the rebound. They score! And they'll strike first on the Adrian College Bulldogs.
Shembri rebound. Shembri was right where she likes to be, behind the net, and the offense runs through the captain there. As you can see on the replay, if you're tuned in on Adrian College TV, sent it back out to that slot area, picks up a rebound, and captain gets the goal. Shembri is going to tie with Una Bellin and Kaylee Catterett for the team leading goals with six.
So you mean to tell me we have a three-way tie?
We do.
Shembri, the senior from Canton, Michigan, last play for Beltire, puts the Bulldogs ahead with 5:10 remaining in period number one. Bulldogs are going to strike first, and they are going to be playing ahead. Goes into the southeast corner of the defending zone. Puck is stuck. It's going to go to the Adrian College Bulldogs. 4:56 remaining in period number one. Thank you for tuning in to Adrian College Sports Network, WBAC Adrian, and Adrian College Television on YouTube. Andre Matthews, play-by-play announcer, joined along Matt Kibbe. Goes back to the point for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Giving off to Shembri. Shembri looking for Grias. Going to go to Anderson, but unfortunately she gets tangled up. Absolute bedlam once again in the crease area. And whistle is going to be called as Yondova was hustling off the rink. Bulldogs were trying to get the extra skater, so there's going to be a penalty for the Aurora State Spartans, and it's going to go on number 16, Trevino. It looks like it's going to be a tripping violation.
Yeah, she's going to get called for the trip. There was a shot in front. She went down hard to the ice, and Trevino's going to have to serve 2 minutes here. First time we've seen either penalty unit come onto the ice, and it's going to be in favor of the Bulldogs here, who have a very strong power play.
So the Bulldogs will get the extra man advantage for the next 2 minutes, and the Spartans roster will shrink by one. Goes into the southwest corner of the defending zone. Giving off to Truman at the point. Now back over to Shembri. Shembri. Back over to Truman at the point. And it's going to go back to the Spartans. They have still not blasted down the other side of the rink. Bulldogs have the extra man, who Danish. Giving off to Truman. Goes for the one-timer for Ron Rudin, but goes a little too wide. Shembri has possession of it in the southeast corner. Now back over to Shembri in the southeast corner. Tries to play it out front. And it's going to be batted away by Fosse. Goes into the southwest corner of the defending zone. Going to let one fire. And it's stopped by Fosse with her leg padding.
Another call coming.
And Yondova's hustling off the rink once again. I think we're going to get 5-on-3 hockey in a second, Kibbe.
You got to let him touch it. You're killing too much time. You're going to take it away your 5-on-3 advantage.
And it goes over to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Yondova is off the rink right now, so the Bulldogs still have the two extra skaters for right now. But Spartans still have not touched it. And stripped up once again, this could be trouble. It looks like it's going to be a cross-checking violation for the alternate captain for Aurora. That is number 7, Olivia Mattson, the native from Alaska.
I'm going to correct you there, Trey. That's going to be called for body checking. And, you know, you also could have had a tripping violation at center ice. But either way, you know, I would have liked to see the Bulldogs, they had it fall over their stick and outside of the offensive zone. But either way, you could have seen a 5-on-3 advantage for about a minute instead of the 43 seconds we're getting.
Yeah, unfortunately, the Bulldogs were scrambling. So the players are going to take a break, and so are we. And thank you for tuning to Adrian College Sports Network. Don't go anywhere. There's still more in store.
College has dozens of athletics programs, and winning is a staple on our campus. We have the culture of winning in and out of the classroom. This is a place where young men and women grow into professionals for life. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit AdrianBulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time.
Welcome back to Arrington Ice Arena, where the Bulldogs are going to have a 5-on-3 advantage because the Aurora Spartans have a couple of players in their penalty box, one for body checking and the other for tripping. So, Kibby, what are you looking to do? Because the Bulldogs, this is a great opportunity for them to collapse their defense, but they have 43 seconds on the 5-on-3.
Yeah, you got to expand out and then collapse in on the net. If you can collapse it into that house area, as they like to call it, you'll have a take advantage of it, and you could see a 2-0 lead.
Shembri has possession of it. Over to Bellin. Bellin is going to take it over to the point. And she's going to dish it over to Von Ruden. Von Ruden back over to Bellin. Bellin's going to try and
collapse
the
defense.
Goes wide of the crease. Von Ruden is going to reset. 20 seconds remaining in the 5-on-3 advantage, but the Bulldogs will still remain in the power play opportunity. Bellin has possession of it now, giving it back down to Shembri. Shembri back over to Tupper. Back over to Von Ruden. Von Ruden giving over to Bellin once again. Von Ruden, they're passing the puck around a lot. Goes high of the crossbar, below the goalie line. And the Bulldogs are still going to be in the power play as checking back into the game is number 16, Trevino. And it's a 5-on-4 advantage for the next 1:08. So the Bulldogs couldn't capitalize on the 5-on-3, but they still have another power play opportunity.
Bulldogs had the shot that they wanted. It was a cross-ice pass looking for Catherine Trubin and not able to get it as there was a lot of speed on the pass, and she couldn't settle it in on her stick, so it went into that corner. But they had the play there, but you still have the power play. Take advantage of it. You got some good speed and some good shooting ability on the ice right now.
2 minutes, 22 seconds remaining in period number one on the Adrian College Sports Network. They missed the – did they score? They do score! They capitalize on the power play. And it looks like getting credited for the goal for the Adrian College Bulldogs. It's going to go to number 9. Looks like it's Cataract.
Yeah, Kaylee Cataract gets her 7th and takes over the lead for this NCAA women's team in goals.
As Kippy said at the top of the broadcast, Cataract was originally scratched for the game, but she checks back, but she's checking into the game. And she's going to make this a 2-0 advantage. Bulldogs capitalize on the man-up advantage.
There's a lot of confusion on that goal. It trickled in over the goal line, and the official was calling for it, and just a little bit of confusion there, but Cataract gets her 7th.
Bulldogs leading 2-0 here on the Adrian College Sports Network with 2 minutes remaining. Playing along the boards near the bench for the Spartans and near the southeast corner. And it's going to go out of the zone. Bulldogs are going to regain control of it, but they have to come back to neutral zone and reset. Batting off the boards, Cataract hustling for the puck. Trying to center off a pass to number 12, Lindsay Sorrell, but misses possession of the puck. Goes back to the point. And Trubin was just able to hit it in. We have 90 seconds remaining in period number one. Bulldogs on top by a score of 2-0 here on the Adrian College Sports Network. Bulldogs up 2-0, and the Spartans looking to chip into the lead before the start of period number two. They're just going to dump the puck in, line shift for both respective teams, and icing is the call. Anderson got there first. We're going to go down the other way for a faceoff.
Yeah, exactly what you want to see if you're the Bulldogs. You get two goals here in the first period. You stay on top and you don't let them get out of the zone. Aurora hasn't been able to establish anything all game long. Bulldogs playing exactly how they need to play in this one.
Grias is going to get the faceoff for the Adrian College Bulldogs. She wins it, goes back to the point for Riley. Now back over to Anderson. Goes into neutral zone. Riley's there to greet it. Tries to hit it in, and it's going to go back to the Spartans. They're going to charge up the way. 3-on-3. Yandova doesn't even need to make a stop as it goes wide of the crease. Anderson has possession of it now near the bench for Adrian College Bulldogs, and it's going to go back into neutral zone. Batting it off the boards. Adrian College has possession of it now. Anderson gets a little too antsy, and it looks like offsides is the call, so we're going to go back to neutral zone for a faceoff.
Yeah, a little bit of ants in the boots there, going in a little bit too soon with Brooke Shembri and Anderson, and puck not able to catch up with them. But either way, you get an opportunity here, take advantage of it, get into the offensive zone, and get a third goal here. Aurora got to get the momentum going into the second.
43 seconds remaining in period number one, the first period of regulation. Bulldogs on top by a score of 2-0 on the Adrian College Sports Network. Swiping away is Von Ruden, but is she going to take it herself, or is she going to wait for one of her teammates? She looks like she's going to take it herself. Knocked down in front by the Aurora Spartans. Rattles it around the southeast corner. Goes back to the Spartans.
Ooh.
Checked really hard.
Wow.
Yeah, penalty is going to be coming.
Wow.
Heard the impact from here. Body check is the call, obviously.
Stemple ran her over. And that's an obvious 2 minutes, but wow. You want to talk about physicality. Emily Stemple is the name of the game.
Emily Stample, the native from Saginaw, Michigan, is going to be spending 2 minutes for that body check. Yeah, Kip, you can hear the sound and the impact from where we are. That was very loud. And unfortunately, too much physicality right there, even for the sport of hockey. We're going to get ready for the faceoff in the attacking zone near the northeast corner. Yandova is going to hold on to the puck, and we're going to get ready for another faceoff.
Yeah, smart play there by Yandova, especially on the power play. Any chance you can let your team reset, even if it's only 2 seconds into the power play, take advantage of it, get the faceoff, try and get the clear after.
A little too antsy on the faceoff, so we're going to try this again. Goes back to the Spartans. They have 15 seconds remaining, and they have the man advantage. Bulldogs are just going to look to blast it down to the other side of the rink, and they do so. They clear the ice. Hustling for the puck is Ed. She's going to take possession of it. Belland is trailing right behind her. Von Ruden able to just knock the puck up, and that's going to signal the end of period number one. Bulldogs on top by a score of 2-0. And Stemple is still going to be spending the next minute and 40 seconds to begin period number two in the penalty box. So, Kibby, what have you been seeing so far from both respective teams?
You know, I've been seeing a really clean game until kind of the end there where we saw a couple power plays for each side. But realistically, it's been a really good game, back and forth contest, exactly what you kind of expected going into this one. The Bulldogs maybe started out slow, but they kept the pressure on the whole entire time. Aurora really needs to find a way to get into the offensive zone. They're going to have to take some chances, but you also kind of got to shorten up your passes, get into the zone. Once you establish it, trust yourself there and get back into the contest. You're only chasing two. It's not that big of a margin. It could be worse. But I want to give a shout-out to Fosse, who has been playing absolutely tremendous in net for the Aurora Spartans.
Yes, she has. And hopefully her offense can just give her a couple of goals to work with so that way they're not trailing so far behind. But they do have an opportunity, as stated. Stemple is going to be spending the next minute and 40 seconds in the penalty box to begin period number two. So the Spartans is a good opportunity to capitalize on the power play and just make it a 2-1 game to start period number two. But for the time being, we are going to step aside. Thank you for tuning in to the Adrian College Sports Network on Adrian College Television and WBAC Adrian. I'm Trey Matthews, the play-by-play announcer. Join along Matt Kibbe. We will catch you for the start of period number two. Don't go anywhere.
The Adrian College Media Production House provides opportunities for students to learn and grow live on the airwaves, just like Matt Kibbe.
I've gotten a chance to create a relationship with coaches and teams and learn more from people instead of trying to teach myself something. Got an opportunity to expand my knowledge of sports, hone in on my skills as a broadcaster, and learn about equipment in different ways. You get more of a connection with professors as well.
Providing opportunities, growing leadership. The Adrian College Media Production House. Thanks for tuning in.
Adrian College has dozens of athletics programs, and winning is a staple on our campus. We have the culture of winning in and out of the classroom. This is a place where young men and women grow into professionals for life. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit AdrianBulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time.
If there was one word I was going to use to describe the communication arts program at Adrian College, it would be unique. Students find themselves on the radio, in front of and behind the camera, and directing their own programs. Students learn in a personalized environment that sets them up for a world of opportunities. Are you ready for your moment in the limelight? Learn more about the Rush Communications Center and Adrian College's communications program by visiting adrian.edu today. Want to learn more about Adrian College Television? To find out more about ACTV, you can visit our website at adriancollege.tv. You can find direct links to our Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and other social media platforms there. Bulldog students can submit a request to become an announcer for ACTV. Fans can see press releases about upcoming events and what's happening at the media production house. Visit adriancollege.tv for more.
Oh, hey, there he is, Bruiser. Hi, I'm Bruiser's biggest fan. He was a legend to us puppies.
Strong but silent. Such a humble attitude from such a prominent figure.
He ran Adrian College's campus. Everyone loved him and wanted to meet him wherever he went. Welcome week, homecoming, spring concert, he was there and looking good. Well, he did have his own private groomer. He was so cool. He had the best education a bulldog could ever ask for, as many walks as he wanted. Heck, the dog had his own pastor, Richie. Bruiser was an athlete, but I'm so small. He did have to work hard at it. Well, maybe not too hard, but it will take a lot of commitment and practice if I want to land on varsity at Arrington too. It's just such a big jersey to fill. Seriously, huge. But I can do this. I want the job. Because I want to make thousands of Bulldog friends just like him. So hi, Adrian College. I'm Bruiser too.
At this time, I'd like to introduce President Docking.
16 years I've been doing this, saying hello to freshman groups coming in. But obviously, this one's different. The friends that you're going to make, the experiences that you're going to have, the memories that you will create are just amazing.
Midnight, I say we lose.
Adrian College's 2020-2021 enrollment has set a new record at 1,865 students. The incoming freshman class of 602 new students helped set the new record. This is the 13th consecutive year the Bulldogs have had an incoming class of more than 500 freshmen. Nearly 6,000 high school seniors applied to attend Adrian College this fall. Why do so many students choose Adrian? Adrian is constantly expanding majors offered to incoming freshmen. If you're a high schooler or know someone who is looking at taking their education to the next level, AC could be the answer. To see the programs Adrian offers, learn more about the process, schedule a visit, and even apply today, visit adrian.edu/admissions. adrian.edu/admissions. We look forward to seeing you on campus.
Want to see the Adrian College Outdoor Performance Band in action? The band performed on Adrian College TV, and you can watch the stream again anytime, anywhere. Professional audio technician Christopher Momini beautifully captured the event, and you can listen to the entire performance now. Visit Adrian College TV on YouTube to listen to the concert.
Welcome to Adrian, Michigan. We're located in a proud college town. Adrian College is situated just 45 minutes from Ann Arbor, Detroit, and Toledo. We're very excited to show you just a little bit of what AC has to offer. This is the gateway to our campus. Welcome to the place that we believe will change the rest of your life. AC features one of the most well-rounded educational experiences in the country. We offer over 60 different academic majors and 10 academic institutes, as well as dozens of student organizations. Year after year, we've been ranked as one of the nation's best colleges, including being one of the most innovative institutions in the U.S. for our medical programs. Our campus is simply beautiful. Our student-to-faculty ratio is an incredible 13 to 1. That means more attention for you and a much better overall learning environment. We know how to put together an education that is life-changing, and these are just some of the highlights. From our communication arts program, to our many performing arts, to the home of business on campus, to our sciences and medical studies, we have the spaces where you can grow into the professional that you want to become. Our first-year student experience is award-winning. You'll make lifelong friends here, meet mentors, and maybe even meet that special someone. The Kane Student Center is open 24 hours a day, and there's a lot going on here. The Bulldog Beanery has all of your hot drinks. Pause and Go is our on-campus convenience store. The bookstore is where you'll get all of your Bulldog gear, and you can just hang out and study in the skyboxes. Not far away is the Shipman Library. The Shipman has quiet, relaxing spaces for you to study in. You can check out books from thousands of libraries around the country, and the Shipman is open 24 hours as well for your convenience. There are hundreds of learning opportunities on campus. In addition to the arts and beautiful facilities, Adrian College is known for its athletic programs. There is nothing like a Saturday game day here in Adrian. The Bulldog football team are 11-time MIAA champions. At Docking Stadium, fans watch soccer, lacrosse, football, and more. Just a few hundred yards away, Adrian College's basketball teams compete. In addition to basketball, fans can enjoy wrestling, acro and tumbling, and volleyball here. We also have a state-of-the-art weight room available to all of our students. When things heat up too much on campus, you can cool off with our ice sports. Our NCAA ice hockey teams are constantly battling in the national playoffs. Just a quick walk down the service drive, we feature one of the best baseball and softball programs in the nation at our level. Soon, you'll be able to cross the street and watch men's and women's rugby take to the pitch as well.
Welcome back to Adrian College Sports Network, Adrian College Television, and WBAC Adrian here at Arrington Ice Arena for this matchup of NCAA women's hockey as it's the Aurora Spartans taking on the Adrian College Bulldogs. We're about ready to start period number two. I'm Trey Matthews, the play-by-play announcer, along with Matt Kibbe. Matt, what have we been seeing? Because right now the Spartans are actually going to be in the power play for the next minute and 40 seconds.
Yeah, we've been seeing a lot of good stuff for the Bulldogs. This is Aurora's first chance to kind of get into this game. They need to cut the lead in half here on this power play. They got about a minute 35 left of it. Take advantage of it. Cut the lead down to one.
Yandova heads to the south side of the rink, and Fosse heads to the north side of the rink, swapping sides. Adrian College Bulldogs looking to kill time on the penalty. And it's going to go back to the Spartans as they play it near their bench. Adrian College able to blast it down to the other side of the rink quickly to waste some time. They have a minute 15 remaining in their penalty. Grabbing possession of the puck was Mattson for the Spartans. Trying to pass it up ahead. Goes to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Von Ruden has possession of it now. Will they try to make a run or will they just blast it down to the other side of the rink? And it looks like they were trying to make a run, but the Spartans are going to swipe it away. Passing up ahead to Schmunk. Lose possession of it. Bellin has possession of it now. Looking for one of her teammates. And she's able to do a little bit of a quick cross pass to Von Ruden, but Von Ruden is going to have to come off. Bellin is going deep into the zone. A number of teammates are there to greet it on the rebound. So close for the shorthanded goal, but unfortunately it just rattles off Fosse. Goes back to Bellin. Bellin out in front of the crease, and Fosse was just quicker.
Yeah, they're going to have to send her there. A little extracurricular there from Aurora, and we're going to see 4-on-4 hockey for the next 30 seconds. And, you know, I was just before that happened, I was about to say, this power play for Aurora hasn't felt like one. It felt like we were just playing 5-on-5 hockey for the past minute and 10 seconds. But either way, now we'll see 4-on-4 hockey. And, you know, I always like to say that benefits the Bulldogs because the Bulldogs have a lot of speed. And when that ice opens up, you can find a lot more open lanes.
So the Bulldogs will remain short of a woman for the next 30 seconds, and then they will enter on the power play opportunity for 90 seconds as the captain for Aurora, Lexi Martinez, the native from Westminster, Colorado, is going to the penalty box. In neutral zone, going into the southwest corner, Riley has possession of it now, looking for one of her teammates. To her left is her teammate, Trubin. Trubin able to pass it up ahead to Miller. Miller going deep into the zone. Can she go for the backhander? She cannot. Lose possession of the puck. And the Spartans are going to charge it up the other side of the rink. 2-on-2. Into the south side of the rink. Bulldogs are back at full strength. And now they are in the power play for the next 90 seconds. They've already capitalized on one power play opportunity this afternoon. Trubin loses possession of the puck. And it's going to go to the Spartans. They touch the puck. And it looks like they're going to get a penalty. And it looks like it's going to be an interference call.
Yeah, so that's going to make it 5-on-3 hockey here for the next minute 15 seconds. A very long kill coming up for the Aurora Spartans, and the Bulldogs weren't able to capitalize last time they had a 5-on-3. But this time, you know, I'm going to take a chance here. I'm going to call on my Johnny Costello prediction.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Bulldogs are going to score here on the 5-on-3.
What are you doing? That goes on Marissa Dunbar. Unfortunately, she didn't let the player get involved in the play, and that will result in a two-minute interference minor every time. Chembri tried to get a shot off, but it was blocked by Fosse. Now giving off back to Trubin, to Von Ruden. Von Ruden back down to Chembri near the northwest corner. Chembri looking for an opening. Bellin has possession of it. Now back over to Von Ruden. Tries to go back door to Grias, but unfortunately it's shut down. Bellin has possession of it now at the point. Giving off to Trubin. Trubin back over to Bellin. Bellin now has possession of it all alone, trying to go deep in the slot. She's going to let one fire. Goes wide of the post, too far to the right of Fosse. Von Ruden has possession of it now. Bulldogs trying to collapse the defense. Haven't done so yet. Von Ruden gets a shot off, but it's blocked in front by the Spartans. And this could be trouble. Going down the other way on the open breakaway. Goes to the backhander and rejected by Yandova. Nice save. Kept her composure. Back over to Shembri in neutral zone. Grias gets in Shembri's way and they lose possession of the puck for a brief moment. Back over to Von Ruden. And the Bulldogs are about to have a 5-on-4 opportunity as Martinez is going to check back into the game after spending some time for interference. So 5-on-4. 5-on-3 opportunity is over. Bulldogs couldn't capitalize on it. You went to your Johnny Costello prediction, didn't you?
I did.
I'll explain the joke when we have time. Goes into the southeast corner as it's batted off Yandova. Back over to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Carmen Anderson tries to pass it but lose possession of the puck. And the Spartans are just going to dump it. They're going to make a line shift of specialty teams. 15 seconds remaining in the power play opportunity for the Adrian College Bulldogs. 16:50 remaining in period number two. Back over to Petrowski in the northwest corner. Trying to pass it around. Going to pass off to Riley. Now back down over to Von Ruden. Tries to go deep into the zone, and Fosse is just going to land on her back, but she holds possession of the puck. And the Spartans are back at full strength and checked in at the right possible time as there's a freeze in the action, so we'll get ready for another faceoff. Shots on goal differential is 19-5 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs.
Don't be fooled by not being able to capitalize on the power play. The Bulldogs still looked really good. Aurora just stood tall and had Fosse in net, who has been playing tremendous, keeping these Aurora Spartans in the contest. This game could be a lot different had she not made some of the saves that she's made.
You are absolutely right. 4 minutes gone by in period number two. Bulldogs still on top by a score of 2-0 here on the Adrian College Sports Network, Adrian College Television, and WBAC Adrian. Thank you for tuning in. At the point area in the zone for Adrian College, they're going to pass it out. And they're going to try to pass in neutral zone to reset. Hustling down for the puck. It goes into the northwest corner. Can the Bulldogs try to make a stop? The Verza knifing at it, rattles it around. Over to Corbett. Lose possession of the puck. Hustling down for it is Corbett. And a little bit of a tussle right now. And it looks like the referees are going to let the players play. Takes it below the goalie line into the southeast corner. Sorrell there to greet it. Just jabs it over. Now goes back into neutral zone for the Spartans. They have to come back and reset. Passing up ahead, trying to go deep. Riley there to greet him. Back over to Sorrell. Sorrell playing along the southeast boards. Back over to Corbett. Now charging up the way is Stemple. Stemple. Is she going to take it herself? She is, but Fosse is going to make an excellent leg pad stop. Goes into the northeast corner. Now goes out of the zone. Hustling for the puck are the Adrian College Bulldogs. Tupper has possession of it now. Tupper passing along to Miller. Pitching it over to Houdanish. Petrowski all alone. She's going to look to get a shot off. Goes high of the crossbar. 14:15 remaining in period number two. Shots on goal in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs by a lot, 20-5. What have you been seeing so far, Matt?
Yeah, you're seeing the Bulldogs try and collapse in on the net and get a good shot in front, but Aurora has been tightening up their defense and Fozzie's been standing up tall.
Miller trying to go deep into the slot and near to the crease area, but gets tripped up a little bit below the goalie line. Goes into the northeast corner. Bulldogs have possession of it. Lets one fire with Anderson. Petrowski is down on the ground.
Yeah, that's going to be an immediate call. Aurora's going to head back to the box here. A simple elbowing call, and Petrowski looks to be getting up on her own power.
Looks like she's in a little bit of pain, but nice to see that she's getting up on her own willpower. The trainers are going to check up on her. And as Matt said, it's going to be a two-minute elbowing call on number 22 for Aurora. Back. 13:47 remaining in period number two. Bulldogs on top of the Aurora Spartans by a score of 2-0 on the Adrian College Sports Network. It's going to go to the Spartans as they won the faceoff in the northeast corner. Back over to Riley. Bulldogs looking to capitalize on the power play once again. And the Spartans are able to clear the ice. Yandova stops it with her stick. She's going to pass it over to Stemple. Stemple looking for one of her teammates. Cross pass over to Anderson. Puck goes into neutral zone. Hustling for it was Grias. She got a little too antsy as the puck was too hot to handle. Offsides is the call.
Yeah, Bulldogs again on the power play, looking to take advantage. It's been a familiar phrase we've been saying all game. We're almost halfway through and only able to capitalize. I don't even think they've been able to capitalize on one, but they've had so many opportunities. No, they have. They have one power play goal. So it has been a really good game, but they haven't been able to really get what we're used to seeing out of the power play unit.
Yes, their one power play opportunity came from their captain, Brooke Shembry. Anderson has possession of it, going deep into the zone, knocked down in front by the Spartans, and Fosse is going to hold on to the puck. And we are going to reset with another faceoff with 13:18 remaining in period number two on the Adrian College Sports Network.
Yeah, now that I look at it, you know, Kaylee Catterett, that was her seventh goal on that power play, made a really nice play, and Chloe Wolfslager got that assist there, so it was just a really good play. But I want to see more of that. I want to see more power play goals out of this Bulldog hockey team.
Well, they have 90 seconds to try to capitalize on the one they're currently in. Riley has possession of it at the point. Pass over to Grias. Grias loses possession of it. It's going into the northwest corner. Now the Spartans are able to clear the ice, and Yandova is going to bat it over to one of her teammates. That's going to be Stemple. Stemple. Riley is right next to her. She's going to pass it up ahead to Von Ruden. Back over to Anderson. Anderson loses possession of the puck. Shembry there to help bail her out. Playing along the boards near the northeast corner in the north side of the rink. Now trying to go deep in the zone. She looks for a wraparound shot, but the Spartans play excellent defense. Von Ruden at the point. Back down. Von Ruden has possession of it. For the one-timer, Stemple off the post. Rattles it around. Goes into the northeast corner. Now playing along the boards, trying to knife at it. Goes back to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Drop pass. And the Spartans are able to bother it. Now back to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Tries to go back door out in front and center off for a shot. But the Spartans are able to knock it down. Too much traffic in the lane. Goes down to the other side of the zone. 15 seconds remaining in the power play for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Could be trouble. Goes to the backhander. And Yandova makes an excellent save once again.
Yeah, Martell came in on that breakaway, tried to go sliding in front of Yandova. Yandova puts on that slide and that butterfly and traps it in there, and we'll see a faceoff. Really nice play there by Denise Yandova.
We've said that a lot. Yandova, obviously a nomination for Player of the Week by Johnny Costello. And she's been playing excellent for this Bulldog organization. At the point, goes into the southeast corner. Bulldogs trying to fish it out, and they do so. Goes into neutral zone, hustling for the puck. Sorrell is going to get away from it. Spartans are back at full strength. Bulldogs couldn't capitalize on that power play opportunity. And unfortunately, they blast it down to the other side of the rink. And icing is going to be waved off, actually. I thought that was going to be a clear call, but the offense for the Spartans were able to get there in plenty of time. Now goes into the southeast corner near Yandova. Back into the deep slot area. It's going to go back to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Miller hustling for it. She gets checked really hard, and the referees are going to let the players play on in neutral zone. Trying to jab at it. Goes back to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Sorrell is going to hustle for the puck. She can't win that foot race in neutral zone. They're going to trash the puck as there's going to be a line shift for the Spartans of Aurora. Playing along the boards. It's going to go to Truban. Truban. Able to dish it off to Hansen. Charging the way of the rink, going deep in the slot. She scores! 3-0 Adrian College on the Adrian College Sports Network with 10:48 remaining in period number two.
Wow, Diverso went top shelf there, and you cannot stop that no matter who's in net. You can see it on the replay here on ACTV on YouTube. It's just a come on in, open net, open season, and finds the back of the net to make it 3-0. Sydney Diversa, absolutely incredible play there, and that's going to give her what looks to be her second goal of the season.
Went top shelf where Grandma keeps the cookies. We're getting ready for the faceoff at center ice. I came up with that phrase by myself, by the way. Goes to the Adrian College Bulldogs, playing along the boards near the Adrian College bench.
Yeah, and I came up with Mother of Mercy.
Goes to the Adrian College Bulldogs in neutral zone. Trying to just keep their foot on the gas pedal. Hopefully they don't go daydreaming. Goes to the Spartans. They shoot it. Bats it away. It's Yandova. They're on the rebound. Nice stop once again by Yandova. Holds on to the puck, and we're going to get ready for the faceoff.
Not very often you see a goaltender give up a save on or get a save on one side, have the rebound come off on the direct opposite side, and Yandova makes a nice play sliding across, puts the pad on, and gets the cover. Exactly what you want to see if you're head coach Sean Skelly out of your goaltender in net.
Yeah, Yandova looked very vulnerable for a second, Matt, but she was able to keep her composure and was just quicker to the puck. Goes to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Grias has possession of it, marching up the zone, gaining it now. Tries to go deep, knocked down in front by the Spartans. Goes into the northeast corner. Now goes to the Spartans. Charging up the way of the zone, able to hit it off the boards near the penalty box for the Spartans. Now goes over to Riley. Riley takes it below Yandova. Back over to Grias. Sorrell demanding for the puck, and she's going to get possession of it as it clanks off the boards near the penalty boxes. Goes to Fosse. Back over to Grias. Grias tried to do a wraparound shot but was rejected. DeVersa trying to get her second goal of the game. Grias there on the rebound. Near the crease area, near Fosse, a little vulnerable. Shots on goal differential is 23-8 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. Thank you for tuning in to Adrian College Sports Network. Now going deep in the zone. Riley, excellent defense. Goes into the southwest corner. Rattles it around, and it's going to go back to the Spartans. Having possession of it is Mattson. Now loses it, and it's going to go over to DeVersa. Now back to the Spartans. Tries to dump it in. Mattson loses it once again. Hustling for the puck is number 34, Martinez, the captain for the Aurora Spartans. These two teams will be back at it in less than 24 hours, but this time the venues will change. It will be played at the Aurora Spartans barn. Line shift for the Spartans. Now trying to gain the zone in neutral zone. 8:50 remaining in period number two. Bulldogs on top by a score of 3-0 on the Adrian College Sports Network. WVAC Adrian and Adrian College Television. Tries to shoot it in. Pad stop by Yandova. Back over to Riley. Riley pitches it over to Corbett. And Cordette is able to hit it off the boards. And holding on to the puck is going to be Fosse. Looks like a penalty is coming up as the referee's hand was in the air.
I'm going to go with that was just a simple icing call. Three-man crew for this officials, two referees, two linesmen, so the referees will have to pick up a little bit of the linesman's typical duties. Could have also been a high stick call on the Bulldogs, which would have called for a whistle, but you got to cover anyway.
24 shots for the Adrian College Bulldogs, 9 for the Spartans of Aurora. Tries to shoot it in, it was Truban, but was knocked down in front by the Spartans once again. Goes into neutral zone. Truban has control of the puck, trying to go past the blue line. Tries to do an excellent pass, and absolute bedlam in front of the crease once again, but able to knock it away was Fosse. Near the bench is Lindsay Sorrell. Over to Grias. Knifing at it, over to Miller. Miller lets one fire, goes wide of the post, not even close. It goes into the northwest corner. Trying to get the puck as it is jammed along the boards near the penalty box for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Miller has possession of it now. All alone in the slot. Lets one fire. Goes off the post. Miller regains the rebound. Looking for one of her teammates. And she hits it very weakly over to Hansen. Grias trying to take possession of the puck. And she does so. Now it's going to go back to the Adrian College Bulldogs as Houdanish has possession of it now. Going back to the point for the Adrian College Bulldogs is Hansen. Back over to Truban. Knocked down in front by the Spartans. 7:14 remaining in period number two. Shots on goal differential is 25-9. And icing is going to be the call. Defense got there plenty of time for the Bulldogs just to take it down to the other side of the rink.
You know, something I want to look at. You know, if you're Aurora and you're, especially if you're Fosse, you know coming into this game that you're going to see a lot of shots. And something to be really proud of if you're head coach Jackie Kostria or Kostria. Then you're going to have a 25 shots on goal, and Fosse's got as many saves going along with that, only giving up 3 goals. Something to be really proud of is that what she's been able to do in between the pipes for Aurora.
She's playing excellent right now for her team, trying to keep them into the game. 7:04 remaining in period number two. Bulldogs on top by a score of 3-0, playing out front of the crease, but unfortunately they lose possession of the puck. Now goes into neutral zone. Tupper. Cross pass over to Anderson. Anderson clanks it off the boards of Aurora. Shembri gets knocked into the boards really hard. And she loses possession of her stick in the process. Belen tries to go for the shot. But excellent stop by Fosse. And the puck goes into the benches. and we are going to reset with a face-off out of play.
Yeah, I'm surprised we're not seeing a cross-checking call coming on that hit on Shembri, but either way, you got to play on and know that, hey, you got to play a little bit tougher than along those boards if they're going to let hits like that go.
Yeah, Shembri was checking into the game, got really hard from the back. I'm surprised there wasn't a penalty call. You are absolutely right. And I guess the Spartans were also surprised because Juliana Gallinero was heading to the penalty box, but her teammates called her back saying there was no penalty. Nice to see Petrowski back into the game. She gets ready for the faceoff at the point area. Goes into the northeast corner. Below the goal in line, Petrowski trying to knife at it. Wolfslager trying to fish it out along with Petrowski. Petrowski is pinned along the boards along with the puck, and she's able to dish it over to Wolfslager. Goes in to the northeast corner. Puck is still jammed along the boards. Who wants possession of it more? Looks like it's going to be the Spartans of Aurora. 6 minutes remaining in period number two. Hustling for the puck is Anderson. Anderson is going to take control of the puck, and she loses possession of it now. The puck is being played in the southwest corner. Shoots it in. They score! Are the Spartans! Went top shelf right over Yandova. The first shot that went right past her. Let's look at the replay.
Yeah, taking a look at it here, it looks like there's a little bit of a miscommunication there, and this puck comes right back in front and finds the stick of the Aurora player. And when you have that and you find a little gift basket in front of the net, go top shelf with it. Yandova can't do much there, and Aurora will get back into this game.
Credit with that goal is number 15, Haley Knopf, the native from Albany, Wisconsin. Last played for Team Wisconsin. 5:57 remaining in period number two on the Adrian College Sports Network. So the Spartans finally chip it to the lead, and their goaltender has been doing excellent right now, Kibby. Do they still have a chance to possibly gain some momentum?
Yeah, definitely. You have plenty of time to do what you need to do to get back into this contest, only chasing two goals. Something I do want to add is Haley Knopf. That's her first career goal as a Adrian College, or as a Aurora Spartan. I'm going to take a quick break.
If you're tuning in to the Adrian College television on YouTube, we apologize for some of the technical difficulties. The camera did go out, and we get it back on. Now it goes back to the Adrian College Bulldogs in the neutral zone. 5:25 remaining in period number two. Bulldogs on top by a score of 3-1. Playing along the boards near the bench for Adrian College. They're going to lose possession of it. Back over to the Spartans in the northeast corner. 5:11 remaining in period number two. Shots on goal differential is 27-11. Goes near Fosse. Able to pass it over to DeVersa. Now goes over to Truban. Back over down, trying to play it out front. Anderson has possession of it now. Truban demanding for it at the point. She's going to let one fire. Weak stick. Goes back to DeVersa. DeVersa just hits it to a Spartan player. Gaining control of it is Gasper. Gasper has possession of it now. Trailing her is Martinez, the captain. And it goes in to the southeast corner here at Arrington Ice Arena. 4:30 remaining in period number two. Bulldogs on top by a score of 3-1 on the Adrian College Sports Network. Out of the zone is Martinez. She's just going to dump the puck in, and it's going to go to the Adrian College Bulldogs with ease. And it's going to go over to Truban. Truban regains control of the puck below Yandova. She gets tripped up and falls onto the ground. Referees are going to pause action, and it's going to be a tripping violation. Easy call right there.
Yeah, some extracurriculars coming because of it, but either way, you see a player go down like that, it's almost always going to be a tripping call, especially when they're playing the puck, and Aurora just on the other side of that one.
So, going to the penalty box is Stephanie Schmunk for the Aurora Spartans, the native from Plymouth, Michigan, last played for Honey Baked. Another player who also played for Honey Baked is number 9 for the Adrian College Bulldogs, Kaylee Catterett. No, Maya Roy, excuse me, number 8. So the Bulldogs are back in the power play, and they have the man-up advantage. Let's see if they can capitalize on another power play opportunity. They've had a lot of opportunities. However, as Kibby described, they've been a little rusty in the power play this afternoon. Von Ruden in the slot area over to Shembri. Back over to Bellin. Bellin, absolute Bellin, and they score! They capitalize on the power play within 20 seconds! 4-1 Adrian College!
Yeah, what a shot there. You find a rebound, and all the name of the game is put shots, and sometimes you can use the goaltender's pads for a pass. That's what it looks like there. You take a shot, find the rebound, send it into the back of the net, and New Danish is going to get a goal here to make it 4-1. Bulldogs answer back.
Number 17, Jocelyn Hu Danish, the native from Palm Coast, Florida.
Yeah, that's going to be her fourth goal on the year. A big one there coming on the power play for the Bulldogs.
3:45 remaining in period number two. Bulldogs answer back with a goal against the Spartans, who scored the last goal, trying to give it deep into the slot over to Wolfslager, but lose possession of it. Now charging up the way of the zone, looking for vengeance, is number 12 for the Spartans, Gasper. Now goes into the southeast corner. Puck is jammed. It's going to go to the Adrian College Bulldogs. They're going to rattle it around over to Anderson. Puck is loose, and it's going to go over to Fosse. And she's just going to tap it over to one of her teammates. Below her in the north side of the rink. 4:05 remaining in period number two. Bulldogs on top of the Aurora Spartans by a score of 4-1. And Fosse is going to hold on to the puck, freeze the action, and we're going to get ready for a faceoff with 2:59 remaining in period number two.
Yeah, it's been all Bulldogs today. Like we've been saying, we spent a lot of time in the Aurora defensive zone. You got to keep up on that pressure and know that you still got to play the game of hockey here. You can't let up off the gas. You got to keep the pressure up, and the Bulldogs are doing just that.
Reagan Petrowski won the faceoff, and she tried to go high, but unfortunately couldn't go top shelf with that. Went a little too high, and the netting gets messed up, so they're going to have to pause action briefly as they're going to fix the netting near Fosse, the netminder for the Aurora Spartans. 2:53 remaining in period number two. Shots on goal differential, 29-11. Goes to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Riley has possession of it at the point area. She's going to rattle it home into the northeast corner. Now back over to Riley. Let's one fire. Strong one. She scores!
Wow.
Strong shot right there. It looks like it's going to be credited to number 17 for the Adrian College Bulldogs, who Danish again.
Yeah, you can see that shot coming all the way up from the point with Jaden Riley, who Danish right in front of the net tipped it up, and that's why we see it take off the water bottle there. And Fosse can't do much there. That's a nice play by Hu Danish.
You know, the only badge or trophy that I won in NHL 19 was not my water bottle, in which you just shoot the puck and the goalie's water bottle gets knocked off the netting and you win a trophy saying, not my water bottle. So, not my water bottle, says the Adrian College Bulldogs as they lead 5-1 on the Adrian College Sports Network. Goes into the northwest corner. Sorrell bodying up. So the Bulldogs have scored two unanswered goals, and they lead 5-1. Goes below the goalie line of Fosse. Now into the northeast corner, all alone. Leg stopped by the netminder for the Spartans. Goes into the northwest corner, near the penalty box of Aurora. Goes out of the zone. And it's going to go over to Hansen. Looking for it is Cordette. Playing along the boards near the bench for the Spartans. Going to dump the puck, and it's going to go easily to Truban. Truban has possession of it now. Trying to gain the zone. Lose possession of the puck. Excellent defense by the Spartans. Goes near the southwest corner. Over to Cadaret. And whistle as referees are going to pause the action.
Yeah, Hu Danish, they just announced it over the loudspeaker. Our guy, Dave Van Giesen, love when he's doing our PA, but fifth goal for Hu Danish. She quickly, in a matter of a few minutes, goes from three goals on the year to five, netting her second tonight. And you really like to see that out of your young freshman if you're head coach Sean Skelly.
Getting ready for the faceoff in the southeast corner. It's going to go to the Adrian College Bulldogs, and they're going to take it into the southwest corner. And the Bulldogs are going to try to charge the way up the zone. The Bulldogs' puck was a little too hot to handle for Grias and or Shembri to handle. 1:15 remaining in period number two. Bulldogs are right now dominating the Spartans by a score of 5-1. Able to hit it away is Fosse for the Spartans. The puck goes out of the zone, and it's going to go over to Tupper. Tupper right now just looking for the puck, a little lackadaisical. Now she regains control of it, trying to tap it over to one of her teammates near the western part of the boards. To the western part, rattles it around. Stemple looking for the puck. It's going to go over to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Back over to Stemple. Stemple trying to pitch it over to one of her teammates. Unfortunately, Grias was not there to greet it, so it's going to go to Gallinaro for the Spartans. Now charging up the way of the zone is Anderson. They're going to try to get a shot off. Goes a little too wide. Now goes below the goalie line on the north side of the rink. Beland has it now going into the northeast corner. Going to take it back to the point area. 15 seconds remaining in period number two. You have time to get one playoff, but the puck is jammed near the benches for the Adrian College Bulldogs. And it's going to go out of the zone. It's going to go to the Spartans. They're going to get one shot off. Lets one fire. Goes wide of the post. Yandova didn't even need to make a stop. And that's going to signal the end of period number two. Bulldogs on top of the Spartans by a score of 5-1 on the Adrian College Sports Network. Kibby, what have we been seeing in this period?
You know, we saw a really explosive second period of action between the two teams, going from a 2-0 tally at the end of the first period to a 5-1 tally here at the end of the second period. It's been a really good game from both sides. Obviously, we're starting to see a little bit more chippiness, a couple more penalties getting called. But either way, it's been really good for the Bulldogs and the Spartans having the opportunity to get into the offensive zone and find the back of the net on a little bit of a fluke play. But either way, I think we're going to need to see the Bulldogs continue to keep on the pressure. As for the Spartans, they're going to need to get into that offensive zone, which they haven't been able to do all game long. The defensive stand for the Bulldogs has been really strong to not even let them get beyond the face-off circles in the offensive zone.
So the final period of regulation is going to be approaching soon. Thank you for tuning into the Adrian College Sports Network, WBAC Adrian, and Adrian College Television. I'm Trey Matthews, the play-by-play announcer, joined by Matt Kibbe. Don't go anywhere. There's still more in store, and we will catch you for the start of period number three.
Kibbe, the current student body president here at Adrian College. I chose AC because the campus simply feels like home. Everywhere I go, I know the amenities are there to help me succeed and get to the next level in my career. If you want to see what Adrian College has to offer, you can schedule an in-person visit at adrian.edu/campus-visit.
Bulldog fans, connect with Adrian College TV on social media to be updated when we're broadcasting live, to see highlights, plays of the week, and much more. Adrian College Television is on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. ACTV's handle is at Adrian College TV on every form of social media. Thank you for tuning in and subscribing to the home of the Bulldogs, Adrian College TV.
Adrian College is looking for leaders, student athletes with the tenacity to keep the Bulldogs at the top, the forefront, in and out of the classroom. The Bulldogs are looking for talent, character, hard work, grit, leaders who can electrify sold-out crowds, got out a last-line shift, will their team to victory, hit a grand slam in the bottom of the ninth, and be a part of a legend in the making. Think you have what it takes to become a Bulldog? Visit adrian.edu to learn more.
sets it in front. Shot set it by MT, but she scores! And Adrian with a dream start in the finals of the MIAA tournament.
I don't even know what we say about it. Like, I'm kind of left speechless after that game.
Next on ice, representing the United States of America, Adrian College.
Did you miss Constitution Day? The George W. Romney Institute for Law and Public Policy presented the annual Philip J. Perkoski Constitution Day Address on Adrian College TV this year.
His presentation, based on his extensive experience in the courtroom, promises to be revealing and thought-provoking. It's called Making the Words Matter, How All of Us, Not Just the Courts, Can Fulfill the Promise of the Constitution. Please join me in welcoming Brett DeGroff.
Using the arc of the moral universe, quote, too loosely, carries with it a danger of magical thinking. Technically, we couldn't have expected the Constitution to do anything about it earlier. It was perfectly legal under the Constitution up to that point. The real action in this area is going to happen at the local level, in cities and in townships, because city and township governments fund and supervise police departments.
You can watch his revealing and thought-provoking speech now on Adrian College TV.
In its 2021 edition of America's Best Colleges, U.S. News & World Report has once again ranked Adrian College as a top regional college in the Midwest. The institution was named to the Best Regional Colleges Midwest section for the seventh consecutive year, and once again listed number two in the Most Innovative Schools category. In addition to these honors, Adrian College was also named to the Best Undergraduate Teaching and Best Value College lists. Adrian College has been established as a distinctive and innovative educational leader in the United States. The institution places priority on a culture of innovation and critical thinking. This is the 12th consecutive year Adrian College has been featured by U.S. News & World Report. You can see the full list of rankings and find more information on their website. For more information about Adrian College, visit adrian.edu. Welcome to Adrian, Michigan. We're located in a proud college town. Adrian College is situated just 45 minutes from Ann Arbor, Detroit, and Toledo. We're very excited to show you just a little bit of what AC has to offer. This is the gateway to our campus. Welcome to the place that we believe will change the rest of your life. AC features one of the most well-rounded educational experiences in the country. We offer over 60 different academic majors and 10 academic institutes, as well as dozens of student organizations. Year after year, we've been ranked as one of the nation's best colleges, including being one of the most innovative institutions in the U.S. for our medical programs. Our campus is simply beautiful. Our student-to-faculty ratio is an incredible 13 to 1. That means more attention for you and a much better overall learning environment. We know how to put together an education that is life-changing, and these are just some of the highlights. From our communication arts program, to our many performing arts, to the home of business on campus, to our sciences and medical studies, we have the spaces where you can grow into the professional that you want to become. Our first-year student experience is award-winning. You'll make lifelong friends here, meet mentors, and maybe even meet that special someone. The Kane Student Center is open 24 hours a day, and there's a lot going on here. The Bulldog Beanery has all of your hot drinks. Pause and Go is our on-campus convenience store. The bookstore is where you'll get all of your Bulldog gear, and you can just hang out and study in the skyboxes. Not far away is the Shipman Library. The Shipman has quiet, relaxing spaces for you to study in. You can check out books from thousands of libraries around the country, and the Shipman is open 24 hours as well for your convenience. There are hundreds of learning opportunities.
Welcome back to Arrington Ice Arena, where the Bulldogs are right now ahead of the Spartans by a score of 5-1 on the Adrian College Sports Network. Thank you for tuning in, whether it be Adrian WBAC or Adrian College Television on YouTube. Glad to have you. I'm Trey Matthews, play-by-play announcer, along with Matt Kibbe. Kibbe, we're about to get ready for the start of period number three, the final period of regulation. What can we see from both respective teams?
Yeah, I think the Bulldogs are going to keep doing what they've been doing all game long. Aurora is going to try and get into that offensive zone. You're going to need a couple goals here before the 10-minute mark to really have a shot to win this game.
Tussling for the puck is Campbell and Von Ruden. And it's going to go to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Yandova and Fosse switch positions once again. So Fosse is going to be in the south side of the rink, and Yandova is going to be in the north side of the rink, like how they began period number one. Adrian College Bulldogs have possession of it. That's Anderson going up ahead. Sorrell gets checked into the boards really hard. That's going to be a whistle. Easy call for the referees as Sorrell is right now on the ground. Excuse me, that is Anderson. And it's going to be a body checking violation on number 12, Madison Gasper, the native from Dunville, Ontario. Too much contact right there, Matt.
Yeah, way too much right in front of the bench, right in front of the referee nonetheless. But something that the Aurora, this is a young Aurora team. They haven't gotten a lot of experience in games. They've only played three up to this point, and we're seeing that kind of inexperience come out with a lot of unnecessary penalties.
So 20 seconds in to period number three, we already have a power play opportunity for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Let's see if they can capitalize on another one this afternoon. Goes in to the southwest corner here at Arrington Ice Arena. Bellin has a possession of it. Passing over to Von Ruden, going into the southeast corner. Back over to Truban, knocked down in front, too much traffic in the lane, thanks to the Spartans. And Falsey makes a very risky play as she leaves the net to try to hustle for the goal. Luckily, there were no Bulldogs there on the rebound. Bulldogs have possession of it now. Going over to Truban. Back over to Von Ruden. Lets one fire. Goes a little too wide. Truban has possession of it. Doesn't really look like a power play opportunity like you've said before, Kibby.
Yeah. Aurora was able to make some nice stops, but the Bulldogs can't really establish that zone. Pass is not getting all the way through.
And looks like there's been a shift of goalies for the Spartans. It's going to be number 31, Tia Gloob, the native from Oakville, Ontario. So Fosse is out of the game. And this is going to be a good opportunity for a new netminder for the Spartans to get some repetitions in to begin this new year.
Yeah, the freshman for the Aurora Spartans getting some playing time here with Fosse playing tremendous hockey. I mean, only giving up five goals, but she took a lot of tough shots and made a lot of great saves. It'll be interesting to see what Gloob can do here as she's making what could be her debut for the Aurora Spartans as a freshman.
So the Bulldogs are able to knife it away. They have 20 seconds remaining in their man-up advantage. Petrowski is all alone at the point, demanding for it. She's going to receive it. She's going to try to let one. Nope, she's going to go and pass it back down. Now back over to Petrowski. Lets one fire. Can't get it through the five hole of Gloob. Goes into the southwest corner. Knifing at it. 5 seconds remaining, and looks like the Bulldogs are not going to capitalize on this power play opportunity as the Spartans are going to be back at full strength after that body checking violation.
Good kill there by the Spartans. That's what it's going to take. If you're going to go to the box, at least kill the penalty.
Stemple trying to take possession of the puck, but is greeted by a bunch of Spartans. But there to help her out was Anderson. Anderson rattles it around, and it goes into the southwest corner. Riley couldn't get control of the puck. Now back over to Anderson down below the goalie line. It's going to go back over to Stemple. Back over to Sorrell. Sorrell just knifing at it in the southeast corner. They're going to pass it back over to the point area. And the puck goes wide. Not even close. It goes into the safety netting near the southwest corner. Unfortunately, Corbett let one fire, and looks like she put a little too much pepper on that biscuit.
I'm going to correct myself here. I should have looked at the stats a little bit before I started speaking. Tia Gloob is the typical starter out of the three games. She's played two of them for this Aurora Spartan, so getting back in net after Fosse gave up those five goals and get some playing time, get ready for this weekend series.
Well, like I said, Fosse actually did pretty well, and you know she just had a lot of shots on goal, a lot of shots that she had to deal with, and as you mentioned, nothing to hold her head down about. Goes into the southeast corner. Clanking it off the boards. It's going to go back to the Adrian College Bulldogs. They're going to give it back down low, and it goes into the southeast corner. Now below the goalie line, wide open, lets one fire. Direct strike at Gloob, and she's going to hold on to it. And we're going to reset with a faceoff with 16-18 remaining in period number three.
Yeah, continued pressure here by the Bulldogs is exactly what you want to keep doing. You got a 5-1 lead, 4-goal lead. You might as well just keep it in the offensive zone and not let the Spartans even consider getting back into this contest. We've only got 16-18 left in the third, and Aurora hasn't been able to do anything.
So we get ready for the faceoff in the south side of the rink near the southeast corner. The Bulldogs have possession of it. Petrowski wrestling for the puck right now. She's able to just give it off to the center near the crease area, but the Spartans are able to swipe it away. They're going to dump the puck in, and it's going to rattle around. Anderson is hustling for the puck. She's not going to win that foot race. However, one of her teammates, Miller, is there to help her out. Now over to Houdanish, who scored twice in today's matchup, looking for the hat trick. Miller loses possession of the puck. Now it's going in to the northeast corner. Yandova is just going to bat it over to one of her teammates. That's going to be Tupper. Tupper is having full possession of the puck and just hits it into the southwest corner. Loses possession of the puck. Petrowski is there. Over to Miller. Miller with Tupper to her left and also Anderson to her left. She's going to give it off to Anderson. And it's going to be a direct strike at Gloob once again. She's going to hold on to it, freeze action. We're going to get ready for a faceoff in the south side of the rink as substitutions come in for both respective teams.
Yeah, with Aurora, they had that opportunity down in their offensive zone. They're taking those long chance passes, trying to get it up, trying to create chances that they haven't had all game long. It's going to come down to what can they do to get it out of the defensive zone, just like that.
And it gets out of the zone, but hustling for the puck was Hansen for the Bulldogs, so great reaction time. It's playing along the western part of the boards near the penalty boxes, and it's going to go near Yandova. Taking control of it is Truban for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Hitting along the boards once again near the penalty boxes. Shembri loses possession of it. Now over to Anderson. Anderson, Shembri is right behind her. She tries to do a drop pass over to Shembri, but to no avail. It goes into the neutral zone, and it looks like the Spartans are going to take control of it. Right there was Campbell. Campbell is just going to dump it in. Line shift for the Spartans, and the Bulldogs are going to take control of it. Right now, Truban has it, rattles it around, looking for one of her teammates. A lot of ladies in white there to greet the puck, and they're able to just hit it a little too far to Carmen Anderson. And Anderson is going to hustle in to the southeast corner of the boards. Now it's going into the southwest corner as Brooke Shembri just tried to do a little bit of a tip pass, but none of her teammates were there to greet her. Playing along the boards once again near the penalty box for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Von Ruden hits it over to Shembri. Shembri is a little bit stuck right now as it was in the southwest corner. Puck goes out of the zone. Bulldogs are going to have to come back and reset. But it's going to go back to the Spartans. The Spartans are going to pass it along. A little bit of a cross pass going deep into the slot area. Goes high at the crossbar. And the Bulldogs try to get there on the rebound, but the Spartans are just going to tip it their way. At the point, they're going to let one fire. Weak stick and too much traffic in the lane to do anything with it. Bellend. A little bit of a tussle for the puck between sticks, but excellent poke check by the Spartans player. Now it goes into the southeast corner. Miller has possession of it. Over there is Corbett. Corbett over to Von Ruden. Von Ruden back to Bellend. Back over to Von Ruden. Von Ruden back to Bellend once again, playing a little game of patty cake. Now it goes into the southeast corner. Now the Bulldogs have possession of it in neutral zone. Skating around. Charging up the way is Bellin. She's going to give it off to Von Ruden. Von Ruden lets one fire. There on the rebound. Sorrell, but unfortunately, she is knocked down. And now she goes into the southeast corner. Yandova hustling off the ice. Penalty coming once again for the Spartans of Aurora.
Yeah, another body-checking call coming. And, you know, if you're Aurora, you're a young team, but you're getting this consistent call. You know the referees are calling it. You got to be a little bit smarter with the body, knowing that you're going to get down, and you haven't gotten a chance to escape your defensive zone at all throughout this whole entire contest, and there's a reason why you're chasing four goals here. Make the adjustments. Got to stay out of the penalty box because this power play unit is really good at, if they don't score, they at least don't allow you to clear it and try and set up a forecheck.
13:06 remaining in period number three, so the Bulldogs will be in the power play for the next 2 minutes, as in the penalty box for the Spartans is going to be their captain, Lexi Martinez. Second time this afternoon she's been in the penalty box. Back over to Riley at the point area. Now back over to Grias. Riley was demanding for it, but they were just going to try to pass it out in front. Couldn't go back door. It's going to go back to Riley at the point once again to reset for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Grias lets one fire, goes behind the netminder. So Riley has possession of it at the point once again. Back over to Grias near the southeast corner. Back over to Riley. Riley's going to let one fire, and she can't trickle it past, but Petrowski is there on the rebound. Back over to Riley. Now back over down to Petrowski. Petrowski is able to pitch it over. Now Petrowski has possession of it. Back over to Riley. Riley lets one fire once again. Can't get through the five hole. Over to Grias. Back over to Riley. To Grias once again. Grias lets one fire, and it's going to go into the safety netting. A little too much mustard on that. So we're going to reset with a faceoff. Obviously, no intention right there, so it's not going to be a delay of game penalty.
Yeah, just trying to clear it out, especially when it hits off the stick and that shot comes up and hits off the netting. The bonus here is since the Bulldogs didn't hit it into that protective netting, they'll get an offensive zone faceoff. That's really huge on a power play unit.
12-14 remaining in period number three. Bulldogs have a minute and 5 seconds remaining in their man-up advantage. Sparns still trying to clear some time. They have not blasted it down to the other side of the rink. Trying to play it up front. Almost right there, but excellent stop by Gloob. Goes into the southwest corner. And the Bulldogs lose possession of it. The Spartans didn't blast it down. The Bulldogs just got a little too sloppy. So it's going to go over to Truban. Truban is going to take it back over to Von Ruden, one of the alternate captains for this team. Charging the way up the zone. Von Ruden trying to do it all by herself. Excellent right there. Goes high of the crossbar, however, with that shot. A little too much muscle on it. Playing it near the boards and near the benches. Now the Spartans are able to clear it. And this is going to kill some time. The Bulldogs have 20 seconds remaining in this power play opportunity. It looks like icing is the call. We are going to go down the other way.
Yeah, we're going to have a penalty here on the Bulldogs. Brooke Schembri is going to sit for 2 minutes for a slashing call. So for 18 seconds, it's going to be 4-on-4 hockey here. And Aurora, you got to take advantage of it. Bulldogs haven't been in the box at all this third period. Take advantage of it. Find that open lane and get it past Gondova and make this game 5-2.
So right now, temporarily, we're going to have 4-on-4 hockey due to the slashing call on Brooke Schembri. She will be spending the next 2 minutes in the penalty box. And the Spartans will regain Martinez in 18 seconds. So once they do, they'll be in the power play opportunity for the temporary time being on the shortened power play opportunity. So it goes into the northeast corner. Spartans have possession of it now, looking to collapse the defense, but to no avail. It's going to go over to Hanson for the Adrian College Bulldogs. She's going to pass over to him to DeVersa. And the Spartans are back at full strength, and they are going to be in the power play. So the Bulldogs in a penalty kill. Yandova is going to hold on to the puck, and we are going to reset with a faceoff as she freezes action.
Yeah, good job there by the netminder. Yandova, the junior for head coach Sean Skelly and company, makes a really good save. Gave up a fluke goal earlier, not really her fault. That puck bounced off of that board, and it kind of just snuck past her there. But she does lead the career totals for shutouts for this Adrian women's hockey team.
Won't get the shutout tonight, but she should still be very proud of herself. But obviously, they still have a game to try to complete. 90 seconds remaining in the power play opportunity for the Spartans. Bulldogs looking to clear the puck. Playing it out front. Absolute bedlam once again. It's chaotic. And Yandova's going to hold on to it to stop the kookiness.
I'm going to continue the praise for Yandova. And she's really doing a great job controlling the rebound, not letting a puck bounce off of her pads and onto the stick of an Aurora Spartan where they can easily put it behind her. But she's doing a really good job of corralling it, finding it, and getting the cover and a whistle.
Shots on goal differential, 38-14 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. That's why they are up 5-1. Goes into the northeast corner, but they are up by 4 goals. Back over to the point area, going deep into the slot, tries to get one in. Playing out front of the crease, they trickle it past Yandova and they score! They capitalize on the power play. 5-2 here at Arrington Ice Arena.
If you're watching on ACTV, you can check a replay here. Live, free, and in HD, you can see the shot comes in. Yandova gets a save at first, and then the rebound is coughed up, and announcer's curse there a little bit. Ian Wentz in the building today, and Aurora able to push it in and get it past Yandova. Exactly what they needed to do on that power play was capitalize on it and get within 3.
Rachel Campoli will be credited with that goal. The 5'8" freshman from Windsor, Ontario, last played for the Southwest Junior Wildcats. Same team as Lindsay Sorrell for this NCAA team, and also Kirsten Horney for the women's D1 organization here at Adrian College. Goes in to the northwest corner. Now all alone once again. Yandova able to make a nice last second stop. So Aurora is able to answer back as the Bulldogs were able to score 3 unanswered goals. Now over to number 23 for the Adrian College Bulldogs. That's Stemple. Charging up the way is Cataract. Cataract taking it deep into the southeast corner. Now over to Stemple. Stemple, the puck is jammed a little bit, and it's going to go to the Spartans as they're trying to hit it off the boards. Sorrell able to swipe it away. Goes deep into the southwest corner once again. Cataract looking to score for the second time this afternoon. Sorrell has possession of it. She can't do a wraparound shot due to the excellent defense, so they're going to pass over to Anderson. Anderson's going to let one fire, and Gloob is just going to snatch it out of the air, hold on to it, and we're going to get ready for a faceoff in the south side of the rink here at Arrington Ice Arena with 9:25 remaining in period number three.
Yeah, Bulldogs doing really well. You know, you give up that goal, and what it really comes down to is you got to be able to move on, get past it, get back into the offense, do what you normally do, and figure it out from a point that you're used to. It's exactly what you need if you're the Bulldogs to act that way. And here with 9:20 left to go, the Bulldogs got to keep up the pressure. Don't let Aurora get back into this thing.
Aurora charging up the way of the rink into the north side. Riley able to just bat it around and rattle it home. Playing along the boards once again. Bulldogs have possession of it. Now they're charging up the way of the rink. That's Petrowski, 2-on-2. She going to do it herself, or is she going to pass it to her teammates? She's going to give it over to Miller. They're on the rebound. Unfortunately, the Bulldogs could not answer. So they're going to take it back to the point area, and they're going to hit it down to the southeast corner. Yandova hustling off the rink. Penalty coming up for the Spartans once again. So the Bulldogs are going to get the extra skater until the Spartans touch the puck. Playing it along near the southwest corner. Now back over. Trying to play it out front. Goes wide. Spartans still have not touched the puck. Bulldogs have the extra skater. Riley. And finally, the Spartans are going to touch the puck. And this is going to be a power play opportunity. It's going to be a body checking once again. And it's going to go on the alternate captain for this Spartans team, Olivia Mattson, the native from Alaska. Body checking, body checking, body checking for the Spartans. That's what's been killing them.
Yeah, it really has. They just keep finding their way back into the penalty box. And, you know, it's very obvious that when you have a skater down, you're not going to be able to get back into this game. It's very hard to get a shorthanded goal. And when you're down that skater, you got to play a lot harder and you give the opponent a bigger chance.
Trubin over to Shembri. Shembri is going to take it deep into the southeast corner. Now back over to Trubin. Trubin's going to let one fire. Playing it out front, and looks like Gloob is going to land on the puck. Freeze action. We're going to get ready for a faceoff with 8:15 remaining in the final period of regulation, with the Bulldogs on top by a score of 5-2. Bulldogs have a minute 47 remaining in their power play opportunity. Thank you for tuning into the Adrian College Sports Network, WBAC Adrian and Adrian College Television. I'm Trey Matthews, joined along by Matt Kibbe. Trubin over to Shembri. Shembri lets one fire. She scores!
Wow.
Just missed it was Gloob. Second goal this afternoon for Brooke Shembri, the captain for this NCAA Bulldog team.
You can see her shoot it from the point. It wasn't meant to be a shot on goal. It was meant to be what seemed to be one of those passes off of the pad. She did not put in her normal shot on that, and it takes the benefit, and a Bulldog bounce goes over the glove of Gloob, and the Bulldogs add to their lead.
Extra man, extra goal. Bulldogs capitalize on the power play. Getting ready for the faceoff at center ice with 8:06 remaining in period number three. Shembri hits it off the boards near the benches. It's going to go back to Gallinaro for the Aurora Spartans. Now back over to Gasper. Gasper hustling up, gaining the zone, going deep into the northeast corner, trying to pass it back. Yandova is going to hold on to the puck and get ready for the faceoff.
You know, we continue to battle for that lead for this team. And now it's between Brooke Shembri and Kaylee Cataract, both with 7 on the year.
Getting ready for the faceoff near the northeast corner. That's going to go to the Adrian College Bulldogs. And the Bulldogs knifing at it. They're going to pass it up ahead to Stemple. Stemple loses possession of it, so Gallinaro is there to greet it. Getting tripped up on her own skates. Looks like that was Stemple for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Shooting it out front. Gloob is not going to let that one get past her. She's going to hold on to it and freeze the action with 7:26 remaining in period number three.
Going to take this opportunity to promote some of our social media. You can find Adrian College TV on all social media platforms. That's Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and even TikTok. Megan Abbey is down making TikToks for us right now.
What is TikTok?
don't know what TikTok is, there's something wrong.
I'm kidding. Just wanted to sound like a granddad. Going into the neutral zone, Bulldogs have possession of it. Passing it up ahead to Stemple. Stemple, she's going to try to drop it back, but unfortunately the Spartans are there to greet him. Stemple is going to try to swipe it away along with her teammate Hansen. Hansen has possession of it now in the northwest corner. Can they look to make a play? They cannot. It's going to go back to the Spartans. As greeting it was Gwillem. Now goes into the northeast corner. Bulldogs passing it ahead to Cataract. Cataract. Sorrell is there to her right. Sorrell was demanding for the puck but didn't get it. Going to Anderson. Sorrell. And it's going to go back to the Spartans. Martinez has possession of it. Now back over to Anderson for the Adrian College Bulldogs. To her left is Denersa and also Petrowski. The Versa misses the puck out in front, so it's going to be given off to Tupper for the Adrian College Bulldogs. It's going to go into the southeast corner. Now into the southwest corner. A little bit of a tussle for the puck. Goes below the goalie line into the southeast corner.
What a move.
Wide open. Tries to do a shot, but it goes off the chest protector for Gloob. And the Bulldogs have possession of it once again. Gloob tried to hold on for the puck, but unfortunately she mishandled it. So we are going to continue with play. It goes into the southeast corner. Once again, Bulldogs just trying to capitalize. Tries to go for the shot. It's Petrowski, but she's rejected. Petrowski trying so hard to get a goal. And it's going to go into the safety netting, hit by the Spartans player. So we are going to reset with a face-off in neutral zone with 5:41 remaining in period number three.
Well, Petrowski put on a couple moves there, and Gloob just was not letting anything get past her. She's trying to keep her team in it here. But either way, Petrowski put on a couple moves, was a pickpocket, one of the best pickpocketers on this Bulldog hockey team.
Grias and also Horback will do the faceoff for the Spartans and the Bulldogs, and it's going to go to the Spartans. Now back to the Bulldogs. And Gloob is going to hold on to the puck once again. We're going to get ready for another faceoff, as a strong shot from the Bulldog player just wasn't strong enough to get past Gloob coming from the point area. So 5:32 remaining in period number three. Bulldogs on top by a score of 6-2.
Time to take another opportunity to promote our ECSN double header coverage of NCAA hockey here at the Arrington Ice Arena coming up at 7 p.m. Marion Sabres coming to town to take on the Adrian College Bulldogs.
We can see the men's hockey players are already entered Arrington Ice Arena getting ready for the start of their game. Matt Kibbe will be on the call. Goes into the southeast corner along with, I believe, Johnny Costello, right?
Correct.
So look forward to that. Doubleheader. Spartans have possession of it. Trying to go deep in the zone, but they're greeted by the great defense for the Adrian College Bulldogs. And they are able to just poke it behind Yondova of her net. So nothing happening right there. It's going to go to the Spartans. And they hit it off the boards near their bench. Going back to Grias. Grias passing up ahead. Going over to Truban. Bulldogs have possession of it now. Lose it once again. Going to the Spartans. The Spartans are able to just bat it away. Goes over near Yondova. Icing is the call. 4:35 remaining in period number three. Shots on goal differential, 47-17. Favor the Adrian College Bulldogs.
Yeah, just a dominating performance in the shots on goal category for the Bulldogs. Been able to find open lanes, take shots. And the Aurora Spartans have stood tall. They've been have a couple blocked shots. They're putting the body on the line. The goaltending's been strong, and it's nothing to be ashamed of. This Bulldog team is just really, really good.
Belland goes deep in his zone. Oh, she scores!
Wow.
Wow! That might be Adrian College Television Play of the Week right there.
Wow, what a move by Una Bellin. She wins that faceoff, gets it back over on her wing side, takes it around, puts on a move, and finds the back of the net with ease. It really came down to the fact that they made it, and Una Bellin put on a move, kept on it. She was patient. Patience can be the name of the game when it comes down to it, so great job there. And now she's going to be tied up with 7 goals on the year. Three-way tie for the goals season goal total for this Bulldog hockey team.
We still have 4:25 remaining in the final period of regulation, Kibbe. Any chance we could see one more goal from the Bulldogs organization?
You know, I think there's always that opportunity, especially with how they're playing, but I would love to see Aurora find the back of the net one more time. I think they need that momentum going in to tomorrow night.
4:05 remaining in period number three. Shots on goal differential is 48-17. It's going to go back to the Adrian College Bulldogs. As taking possession of it was Corbett going deep into the zone, trying to knife at it. Gloob is able to just knock it away. Now out in front of the crease area. Gloob is going to land onto the puck once again. Belland out near the crease area as well on her back. Looks like no intent by both respective teams, just playing really hard.
Yeah, it's been a good game thus far. It's been a really, really good game. It's fun to watch, fun to see this Bulldog team continue on the path that they got going right now. 8-0 on the year, 1-0 in the NCHA. Got to keep doing what you're doing. Keep playing Bulldog hockey.
Playing Bulldog hockey is the way to go here at Arrington Ice Arena, home of seven hockey teams, ranging from the NCAA teams to the men's D3 teams. Miller tries to go deep in the zone, but she is knocked away. Let's one fire. Weak stick. It goes in to the southwest corner here at Arrington Ice Arena. They score once again. 8-2 is going to be the Adrian College Bulldogs.
Yeah, that one's going to find the stick of Emily Stemple, and she's able to do what she does best, put a shot on goal, get it off the rebound, put it in, and find the back of the net. Just an awkward angled shot, but able to poke it in and get this lead to 8-2. And Jay Hanna, our executive producer, score prediction off once again.
Well, he did say 7-2. 3:25 remaining in period number three. Bulldogs, it's been all them this afternoon. They are putting Thor's hammer down on Aurora. Goes in to the northeast corner. 2-on-1, odd man rush. Cordett and Miller, they're going to work together, and Cordett gets the puck knocked away from her. It's going to go back to the Adrian College Bulldogs, however, in the Spartan zone. It's going to go over to Maya Tupper. Now rattles it around, goes in to the southeast corner. Back over to the Spartans. Watching in the southeast corner is the men's NCAA hockey team for Adrian College. Miller has possession of it. Hits it near the boards. Now over to Anderson. She's just going to dump it in as there's going to be a line shift for the Adrian College Bulldogs. And the Spartans are going to regain control of it with ease. Playing in front of the bench. Riley trying to play excellent defense. Gasper is trying to go deep into the zone. And looks like the referees are going to pause action. It looks like it's going to be a hooking violation going on the Adrian College Bulldog player, and it's going to be on Jaden Riley. Unfortunately, you cannot stop skating and use your stick to pull on the player. That will result in a hooking minor each time. Hook that player like a fish.
I'm not going to acknowledge that. I'm just going to let you do your thing here, Trey. I refuse to acknowledge that one.
That wasn't even bad.
I refuse to acknowledge that one.
What? That wasn't even bad. What? Hook that player like a... Okay, you know what? Forget it. We have a game going on. At the point area are the Spartans. They're going to try to collapse the defense and capitalize on their possible last power play opportunity this afternoon. Going down the other way are the Adrian College Bulldogs. In neutral zone, Von Ruden has possession of it, trying to pass it out ahead, trying to get the shorthanded goal, rejected by Gloob. Excellent save right there. It's going to go back to the Spartans as they're going to try to gain the zone. Goes into neutral zone. Von Ruden shoves the player really hard, and we are going to get a penalty. You can hear the sound and the impact from where we are. And it's going to be 5-on-3 hockey as Von Ruden heads to the penalty box with that hit. Body checking is the call. 1:51 remaining in period number three.
Yeah, only a few minutes left to go, but you don't want to see this. You got to keep up and don't lose any of your momentum that you've had all game long, and keep your composure. I know it's been a little bit of a weird game for both teams, but keep that composure. It's really hard to get into the end of the game and then start getting penalties that you haven't had all game long.
So the Spartans are going to look to collapse the defense in their 5-on-3 opportunity, maybe get one final goal to get some momentum for the next game, which is going to be tomorrow at their barn when they host the NCAA women's hockey team here. Passing along, lets one fire off Yandova. Too much traffic in the lane. Goes into the northeast corner, back at the top of the point for the Spartans. Goes wide of the post. Trying to blast it down to the other side of the rink was Hanson for the Adrian College Bulldogs. But going down the other way, the Versa is just not going to able to hit it as there's extracurricular activity going on. as looks like DeVersa just threw a haymaker at one of the Spartans players as she was grabbing, looks like her neck area. For that Spartans, it was number 21, Ava Ed. 1:10 remaining in period number three.
Yeah, looking for that last minute call, but you know, when it comes down to it, it's 8-2. Officials, they might have missed it a little bit, but you know, you want to call it down to the wire, but even then, still an 8-2 game. You already got a 5-on-3 advantage. You're more so looking for it for tomorrow night's action.
Versa might have been frustrated with the opportunity to try to get the shorthanded goal, but it doesn't work in her favor. We're going to get ready for the faceoff in the southeast corner. And it looks like the referees are discussing with the PA announcer here at Adrian College. And it looks like Aurora is going to the penalty box. But looks like it's unsportsmanlike conduct, maybe?
Yeah, it could be that way. It could just be end up being an unsportsmanlike conduct call, but we'll let Joe, or Dave Van Giesen let us know.
Faceoff came in the southeast corner, went to the Spartans as they are going to try to hustle. They're on their horse going deep into the zone. They can't get one in the crease area to try to get it past Yondova. Goes in to the northeast corner for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Now back to the Spartans at the point area. That is their captain, Martinez. Martinez tried to let one fire and try to make a play happen, but to no avail. Absolute bedlam once again. Yondova is going to hold on to it with 40.2 seconds remaining in the final period of regulation.
Yeah, the chippiness picking up here. Both teams not going to finish at that even strength number, 5-on-5 hockey. Yeah, you got to keep it clean, finish this game out, get out of the rink, get on ready for the next game tomorrow night.
Looks like we are going to continue to have 4-on-3 hockey for the next 17 seconds when Riley checks back in for her hooking call. Looking for an opportunity. Too much traffic in the lane. And the referees are going to pause action.
Yeah, that shot came in hard. It went off of the skate of Trubin and then went all the way up into the protective netting. That's a way to put the body on the line.
31 seconds in the final period of regulation. Bulldogs on top of the Spartans by a score of 8-2. Faceoff came in the northwest corner. Whistle once again as Yondova holds on to the puck. 26 and a half seconds remaining in period number three. Riley will be checking back into the game in about 3 seconds, and then we will get 4-on-4 hockey here at Arrington Ice Arena. Riley is back in, and the Bulldogs and the Spartans are now playing 4-on-4 with 15 seconds remaining, and they will do so barring any last-minute penalty calls. 5 seconds remaining. Puck goes into the northeast corner. Just passing it around. Just hits it to no one, and the Bulldogs are going to come out victorious by a score of 8-2.
Yeah, a really good game when it comes for the Bulldogs. They put together a really good game plan, came in and put it to use. They kept the Aurora Spartans out of the offensive zone, and they played really good defense when they ended up being there. Gave up 2 goals, one of them kind of a fluke, and another one just a really good shot by Aurora. But either way, you come into to the barn tonight and you play really well and you go to victory, and a conference victory as you're defending your NCHA championship from last year.
The Spartans and the Bulldogs come to their respective blue lines to salute one another as a sign of good sportsmanship. And with that, I'm going to have to say so long for now. But don't go anywhere. There's still more in store on Adrian College Television. Don't miss the NCAA men's game as Matt Kibbe will be on the call with Johnny Costello. And the Bulldogs NCAA women's team comes out victorious by a score of 8-2. I'm Trey Matthews, your play-by-play announcer. As always, joined by Matt Kibbe. Thank you for tuning in to the Adrian College Sports Network on Adrian College Television and WVAC Adrian. Bulldogs right now, the score was 8-2. Shots on goal differential was 51-18 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. This is Trey Matthews saying good night, everybody.
Want to learn more about Adrian College Television? To find out more about ACTV, you can visit our website at adriancollege.tv. You can find direct links to our Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and other social media platforms there. Bulldog students can submit a request to become an announcer for ACTV.
fans can see press releases about upcoming events and what's happening at the Media Production House. Visit AdrianCollege.tv for more.
Adrian College has dozens of athletics programs, and winning is a staple on our campus. We have the culture of winning in and out of the classroom. This is a place where young men and women grow into professionals for life. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit AdrianBulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time. Are you looking to continue your athletic career while also pursuing your educational career? Adrian College houses dozens of varsity and club programs right here on campus, along with 77 undergraduate degrees and 47 majors. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit AdrianBulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time. Adrian College is a pinpoint like no other. With our 77 undergraduate degrees, 47 majors, and 21 broad fields of study, Adrian has a one-of-a-kind, hands-on learning experience for everyone. Do you want to visit the campus of Adrian College in person? Visit adrian.edu/campus-visit. Again, that's adrian.edu/campus-visit. Come take in the beautiful facilities at Adrian College for yourself.
I'm Matt Kibbe, the current student body president here at Adrian College. I chose AC because the campus simply feels like home. Everywhere I go, I know the amenities are there to help me succeed and get to the next level in my career. If you want to see what Adrian College has to offer, you can schedule an in-person visit at adrian.edu/campus-visit.
If there was one word I was going to use to describe the communication arts program at Adrian College, it would be unique. Students find themselves on the radio, in front of and behind the camera, and directing their own programs. Students learn in a personalized environment that sets them up for a world of opportunities. Are you ready for your moment in the limelight? Learn more about the Rush Communications Center and Adrian College's communications program by visiting adrian.edu today.
Bulldog fans connect with Adrian College TV on social media to be updated when we're broadcasting live, to see highlights, plays of the week, and much more. Adrian College Television is on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. ACTV's handle is at Adrian College TV on every form of social media. Thank you for tuning in and subscribing to the home of the Bulldogs, Adrian College TV.
The Adrian College Sports Network wants you to join us in thanking one of our sponsors, the Carlton Lodge of Adrian. The Carlton Lodge offers a comfortable and convenient lodging experience. Carlton has spacious rooms and suites fit for a peaceful night's sleep. Their amenities include a hot tub and pool, a 24-hour fitness center, a business center, and much more. A huge thanks to Adrian College's choice of lodging for sponsoring Bulldog Athletics.
Especially if that happens in the first period,